As I mentioned, fleet is very much a special purpose type of building. And research and evaluation, we identified an existing facility in the city along Commerce Road that currently operates as a vehicle maintenance facility. It is a total of 10 acres, 65,000 square feet. As I mentioned, it currently performs vehicle maintenance functions. Our project will relocate 56 city employees to the Commerce Road corridor. The seller is asking $4.5 million for this property, and the city is very aware of the fact that the vacancy rates along Commerce Road are extremely high, and this is an area of the city that we think holds significant potential for economic development in the future, for job creation, and what better way to stimulate that than to take city services and city employees and relocate them to that area in hopes that private investment will follow on. Oh, let me just back up. One other point I want to make is we are also evaluating this property. Given the size of the property, we believe that there's a potential for locating other phase two elements of the Boulevard relocation to this property, but that will, a programming study will inform us as to what types of uses and how much use we can add to this site in addition to fleet. The next property is located at 2395 Hermitage Road, and this building will be housing the functions of Richmond Public Schools purchasing and warehousing along with their telecommunication services. The building sits on 3.3 acres, 40,000, just under 41,000 square feet. We will be locating 45 Richmond Public School employees to this site with a 10-year lease. We retain the option to purchase this building after the fourth year. The base rent will be $183,892 per year. We will also pay amortized tenant improvements of about $87,000 per year. Now, let me just tell you that the lease contemplated here will be by and between Richmond Public Schools and the property owner. However, the city has made a commitment to fund this lease. So earlier this week, we put forth a paper which was a funding agreement between the city and Richmond Public Schools that memorialized the fact that the city would be responsible for the rents related to this facility. And then lastly, there's the Richmond Public Schools facilities management function. We had identified a property for that function. However, the property owner did choose another purchaser. So we went back out to the market. We think we've identified a great solution, and we believe that we can accommodate Richmond Public Schools facilities management with a 7.9 acre site, 50,000 square feet that would house their workshop space, driver's education, 100 employees, and we're working under a budget of $2.7 million. I will tell you that a paper will be forthcoming for the acquisition of a property to house this function. So a little bit about next steps, just so you understand our methodology and sort of the next steps, action items that we'll be taking as it relates to this Boulevard repositioning plan. We will be completing environmental assessments by September, or they have work completed in September 2012. We'll complete a phase two space planning study, and that's the next group of public works functions that need to be relocated. We'll be completing that space planning study January 2013. Fleet management is expected to relocate by March 2013. RPS facilities, maintenance, and purchasing will relocate August 2013 over the summer. And then building abatement and demolition plan is scheduled to be completed September 2013 with complete site remediation by October or November of 2013. So with that context, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Lassiter, who will present the elements of the funding for this project.
Madam Chair, committee members, Wayne Lassiter. What you've just been given is what I hope, a very simple and straightforward layout of the funding for the properties on Commerce Road in the presentation you just heard. There is a project in the CIP budget already entitled Boulevard Redevelopment Preparation Project, and in that project, $3.3 million was appropriated. In addition to those funds, we're proposing to transfer three items from the general fund, the first being $2,168,000 from the Miller Roads project, which will redevelopment. At the end of any fiscal year, we go through all outstanding grants to see where they are, if they're going to be closed out. We did that this year, as we normally do, and we've identified some money from grants. These were two weather-related events that the grants pertain to. They have been closed out. We have confirmed that no further money is expected back from the city. So we're proposing to transfer $383,000 from that source. And then the DPW operating budget in 13 had a sum of money in there for leasing properties. And we're proposing to take $100,000 from that operating budget. A total of $2,651,000, transfer that over to this Boulevard project. And then the last remaining item is coming from DPU, amount of $396,000. The way we derive that is the fleet service DPU to all five utilities. And that's a calculated amount that we believe utilities appropriately contribute to the project. So all of those funds, $3 million plus what was already there, give us $6 million plus $4.5 million to be used for the purchasing of these three properties, leaving $1,900,000 and some odd thousand to do remaining work. Any questions on this?
Okay.
We have a contract for Commerce Road. We have a contract for Commerce Road. Is there going to be any mediation work or anything like that that needs to be done at that site?
Yes, we've had environmental assessment done on that property, and we have identified some environmental impact, and we're currently working with the seller as to how that those issues are going to be addressed. But the seller has indicated a willingness to take care of all the issues related to the property.
On the Commerce Road, please call me Ms. Ferrara. On the Commerce property, what was the assessed value?
I don't have the exact figure with me today.
What?
It's in here on page 2 or 4.
Thank you.
The current assessed value is $4,250,000.
Okay. $4,250,000. Okay, good. All right. The next question I have, and then I'll come back to Mr. Lassiter.
But as we do that process, we are internally working on an analysis assessed values to, we're looking at assessed value zoning, we're looking at potential development of the area, what that can mean, as well as, for lack of a better word, a programming of what the city needs, what that area is useful for, so that we can line this all up to not have any gap for the time we are able to make these moves, to get it clean, to get it remediated, to get an RFP on the street, to get that site developed. So everything from the analysis we're doing on existing potential for the site, and in that, I mean, looking at the whole area, looking at assessed values, looking at trends, and doing our internal study of the area, setting ourselves up to immediately put an RFP out to begin the development in this area. We're trying to time it all so that it runs in parallel. So there is a master plan to get this move, to get these functions off, knowing that there is a higher, better use as we put forth the plan and the RP and get that on the street. But we're trying to do all in a time method so that the first quarter of next year, we're ready to start that process, and there's no gap in between moving or waiting or in seizing an opportunity we have in front of us now.
Okay. All right, that's helpful. I appreciate it. Again, I feel like I don't have a complete understanding of where we're trying to go, what it's ultimately going to gain us. And my concern is there's going to be a gap. And what you're telling me is that you're trying to avoid that gap.
This whole process is really several pieces running together to avoid any gap and to seize on the opportunity. Presently, the opportunities we have for the needs, but at the same time, to have our plan in place, to have our idea in place and our analysis, so that when this is done, when functions are moved off and land is available and ready, that we are already in the next step moving forward to have action on that parcel. That's part of the reason, or that's the timing of this plan, is to make it happen with no gap in between.
All right, thank you. And Mr. Lassiter, I have some questions with regards to the numbers. The way I see this, and I just want to make sure I'm clear on this, 3,375,000 CIP loan, right? And the 3,047,986 is general fund money.
Well, not part of that 396,000.
All right, so if I take out roughly 400,000, it's 2.6 million of general fund transfers.
Correct.
Okay. And the utility transfer, how do you category put that in?
It's a 396,000 listed there transfer from utilities. Are you asking how we calculate?
I mean, is it a general fund number?
That is truly a contribution from utility funds. It has nothing to do with the general fund.
It's a contribution. Does it go against the number that we normally receive from you?
No.
This is an addition to?
It's utilities contribution to a capital project. It has nothing to do with any other dollars that you normally get from utilities.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
I just want to give, I don't need an answer to this today, but I want to try to work with the administration on this Hermitage Road lease. I know that the school has some surplus property that they could use for these kinds of issues. And I'm trying to figure out why we need to lease space when we have surplus property that perhaps we could help them enhance to bring it up to snuff instead of paying. Was $183,000 a year for 10 years on the lease property. You guys don't have to answer that today. That's the question that I want to lay out in front of you. Give me time to look at it and come back to me. I don't want to put you on the spot today with it, but that's where I'm headed.
Any other questions?
Based on what we had before, this year's CIP program, there's...
What is appropriated in this budget? You've got too many here that have not had a use at the present time. This is the anticipated budget for what it would cost for the relocation from the Boulevard to Commerce. Is that correct?
In this year's budget, in CIP budget, we have roughly $3.4 million, which is going to accomplish many things. It's going to do site demolition, remediation.
I'm understanding that is already included in the budget that we had before.
Yeah.
We have $3.3 million from the CIP and the paper that is before us today for a request of $3.047 million. And I'm asking, is that the total budget for the cost for the relocation from the Boulevard to Commerce? Do we anticipate additional costs that are needed in this year to cover the cost for this relocation?
Are you talking to physically move people from Parker Field to different shopping level?
I'm talking about any relocate for the entire budget for the Boulevard project. This is the full budget that we expect it to be for this year. And we wouldn't anticipate that there's no additional costs associated with this relocation. Not just this year, the relocation.
There's no additional funds that are required. There is another CIP project, which is approximately $3.4 million, which includes costs such as the physical relocations, site remediation, and whatnot. So everything we need is in the budget. So I guess what I'm trying to say.
Okay, let me be clear,
because
I'm not sure that I'm understanding what you're saying, and I just don't want to be confused in the process. Right now, this budget before us, the preparation for the relocation of the Boulevard to Commerce Road, is a total of the current CIP budget, $3.3 million, plus the amendment that is before us currently of an additional $3.047 million. And my question is that the budget, the project cost for the relocation from the Boulevard to Commerce? Or are there other costs that we anticipate in order to make this transfer done?
There's going to be physical costs to take people that are physically on Parker Field now and put them in on this property. But that money is currently in this year's CIP program under the Boulevard remediation project.
Okay, so there is another line item in this current budget that deals with the Boulevard.
Yes, there is. And it was, I can get you the exact number, but it's for roughly $3.4 million, and it does a variety of tasks, one of which is to physically relocate the employees and their equipment from Parker Field to this new location.
And is that money in the CIP budget as well, or is this money in the general fund budget?
It's in CIP.
And there's an additional $1 million in the non-departmental budget.
That is correct. That is for what we're calling our phase two. Right now we're moving fleet facility and what we call RPS's White House. Mm-hmm. We still have to move the radio shop, the salt dome, other DPW functions, and $1 million is in non-departmental. Is to do the remediation work and planning for that phase, what we're calling phase two.
And when is phase two? What's the timeline for phase two? And is the $1 million that is non-departmental plus the additional $3.4 million that is in the CIP? If I was trying to application for the $3.4 million in the CIP. How is that identified in the budget?
I believe it's under facilities. I have my CIP book. I could actually point it to it.
It's, the tag is Boulevard Redevelopment Project. $3.375 million
Now, this is the reason why I'm asking that, because if the 3.37 that staff is referring to is already included in this project right here, that's not an additional $3.4 million. So, am I understanding you to say that there are two line items of CIP funding in this year's budget? One is 3.375 and an additional 3.4 for the Boulevard.
Well, the project that I was talking about, it has a 3.4, which includes building demolition, site remediation, relocation of the employees. That's the number that Mr. Hurst gave, the 3.4. I estimated it to be 3.4, I'm not knowing exactly.
So roughly we're talking $10 million in this budget. With this transfer, we're talking $10 million. Roughly.
There's this plus the 3.4 is currently in the budget.
Is that correct? Okay. I'd like for us to get a budget sheet that identifies all of the funds that are in the budget for the development, for the Boulevard project. This covers what is in the budget for the CIP for the 3.375, but it does not include the 3.4 for facilities that you're speaking of. Neither does it include the $1 million that is in the non-departmental budget. Is that correct? That's my understanding.
Yes, that's my understanding. I want to confirm a point, but that's my understanding, yes.
I'm going to abstain.
Madam Chair, can you repeat that motion?